Good evening, and welcome to the American Cathedral in Paris. My name is Zach Ullery, and I'm the canon for music. It is my pleasure to welcome you to our first virtual organ recital series. On the first Friday of every month, we'll be joined by brilliant organists from all around the world, who at some point in their career were affiliated with the American Cathedral. Tonight, we travel to New Canaan, Connecticut, where we're joined by our former canon for music and dear friend, Ned Tipton, who will present the first recital in this series.
Greetings, everyone, wherever you are, and welcome to St. Mark's Episcopal Church in New Canaan, Connecticut. Bonjour à tous et à toutes, où que vous soyez, et bienvenue dans l'église épiscopale Saint-Marc à New Canaan, dans l'état de Connecticut. Thank you, Zach, for that introduction, and thank you to the committee, especially Charlie and Jennifer, for the invitation to play this first recital of the First Friday's Organ Concert Series. Now, how did I first come to the American Cathedral? Long story short, I spent the school academic year 1979-1980 in Paris at the École Normale de Musique, training to be a concert pianist. However, November the 11th, 1979, I happened to come to a service at the cathedral, my first time ever there. Later joined the choir in the spring of 1980 and sang for the rest of the season, the spring season of 1980. At the same time, I began to realize that I didn't want to be a concert pianist, that I wanted to live my life as a church musician. I also decided that if the job at the cathedral were ever to open up, I would apply. This is what happened in 1989. All total, I have spent one-third of my life in Paris at the American Cathedral. 21 very happy years. Zach asked me to provide an amusing story related to the organ and my experience there. February 21st, 1993, we rededicated the organ after over a year of work during a big, actually over-the-top service of Evensong. Our dear Olivia de Havilland read the lessons. The majority of the funds to restore the organ were given by Geneviève Paulet, who was a parishioner at the time, representing the Paulet Foundation of Paris and Dallas, Texas. Geneviève had asked me if I would play the Vidor Toccata as the postlude for that evensong, and I said, yes, of course. Now, we had discovered that there were problems because of the fact that the power supply between France and the United States is different, France being 220 volts, the United States 110 volts. In fact, we had system failures several times in the days leading up to the evensong, but we managed to get it working again. So, I'm playing the surface, I'm playing the postlude, and Stuart Wayne Foster had the hood of the organ up, and he was watching these specific circuit boards to see if they were going to start turning red, the little lights turning red, indicating the system was about to go. And sure enough, the circuit boards lights started turning red. He said, Ned, you have to stop. I said, no, I can't, because I was a page and a half from the end. I said, I just know I can get to the end, which I did. But at the end, as I played the last chord, there was a faint smell of burning circuit board in the air. I had burned them out, a few of them. Our newly restored organ was unusable until we could get some more circuit boards rushed to us from the States to Paris. I'll start with a work by a great American composer and organist, Calvin Hampton. Calvin's trumpet tune features our big trumpet stop, which we also call our party horn. I'll play an abridged version of this piece, omitting the complete repeat of the main section of the piece that Calvin actually asks for. I recorded this piece for a service earlier this year here at St. Mark's. Here's Calvin Hampton's trumpet tune. Our 1961 Austin pipe organ here at St. Mark's can actually play a lot of different repertoire very well, especially the music of Johann Sebastian Bach. His beautiful and festive Prelude and Fugue in A major is a wonderful piece, but not often played. The main theme of the fugue, or the subject as it's called, is rhythmically somewhat ambiguous. In that you're not quite sure, is it in 2-4 time, is it in 3-4, 6-8, it's not clear. Unless you play it in the way that Bach would have played it, with his feet, all with your toes, which would then result in phrasing that would make the rhythm clear, put it squarely in 3-4 time. Pedal boards these days are designed differently to allow the player to play with his or her heels and toes. I will be using a few heels here and there on the fugue subject, so please forgive me, but I hope the result brings clarity to this wonderful music. Here's the subject of the fugue played pedals only, followed by Prelude and Fugue in A major of Bach.
Thank you.
Charles Tournemire had a long and distinguished career, and in our case, organist, at Paris's Basilique de Sainte-Clotilde, the very beautiful church sort of behind the Assemblée Nationale, and built in the 19th century, and which was the very first Gothic Revival building in Paris in the mid-19th century. Tournemire composed an enormous, monumental set of organ pieces for just about every single Sunday of the church year, the series he called L'Orgue Mystique, the mystical organ, probably because he felt that the music of the organ gave a mystical, almost magical beauty to the service of worship. Each set included a prelude to the introit, the offertory, the elevation, the elevation of the host, the communion, and the pièce terminale, or the postlude, if you will. And all were based on the Gregorian chants, which would have been heard or sung during that particular service. Certain occasions inspired him more than others, specifically the Sundays when the lessons were about specific events like Christmas and Easter. The Feast of the Epiphany is certainly this way. It's a mini nativity scene, complete with three kings, stars, gold, frankincense, and myrrh, all set to music. Before each movement, I will show you the chants that inspired Tournemire's colorful writing. Here's the office for the Feast of the Epiphany by Charles Tournemire.
Thank you.
Before I play this last movement, I would like to thank our rector here at St. Mark's, the Reverend Peter Walsh, Father Peter, and the staff here at St. Mark's, especially Megan Farrell, our communications director, for their support and encouragement. The staff here were almost as excited about me playing this recital as I was. And again, Canon Zach Ullery and the committee for inviting me to play, Les Arts Georges Cinq for their continued support of the Cathedral Music Program, and most especially, the very Reverend Lucinda Laird, Dean, for her continued love and caring for both the Cathedral as a holy place and for all who work, worship, and serve at the American Cathedral Church of the Holy Trinity, Paris, France. La Cathédrale Américaine de la Sainte Trinité, Paris.